love, light, abundance, gratitude, peace. Whew. Love and light to you all. Welcome to a new day. I give thanks for a brand new day. I give thanks for all the hours in this day and that I have enough to do all that I need to do. I am so grateful. It's 5:55. I give thanks for the energy of that number and what it means to me and how it snatches my attention and keeps me alert. So during this season when I am going live on a daily, all day things are popping out to me. They are loud. I'm not joking when I say I'm on assignment. Like, my ancestors got me on assignment. And I am on alert. And this little, it's because I'm detoxing. And whether you know it or not, if you feel that scratching your throat or you constantly clear your throat throughout the day, that is mucus trying to get up out your body. I'm taking capsules that is detoxing or ridding my body of the mucus, and that's why I keep doing that. I have a song that was really loud to me last night. Speaking of all things being loud, this song was very loud. And it was my first time ever hearing this Usher song. It's called Tell Me. And it was so fitting for the point of this conversation. So it's called Tell Me. And a certain part of this song gets into detail about the exchange of sex. And yeah, we're just going to let this ride. It caught my attention as I was working last night. And I was like, what is he saying? Is that Usher? I had never heard this song before. But yeah, it's, this song, take the time to listen to it when you guys have a chance today, and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about, because the more I'm away from you, the more of you I want. So it's like, it explains the magnetism between people energetically, and that part, the more I'm away from you, the more of you I want. And then when you get together, how enhanced and heightened that energy is. And I just feel like this whole song is a spell. It's casting a spell. He's like, I want to hold you till I can't feel again, until your soul lets me in. So please understand, I felt like this was just so vital to bring up, because I was talking about how your soul literally exchanges with the other person. But be intentional about that. Like, I was having a conversation with my cousin about empty sex, casual sex. I can't. I can't even have sex with somebody I'm not interested in. And I found out that that's a thing. Like, you just, I cannot. What we're doing is so much more than sexual tonight. It's much more than just sexual intercourse. This is a energy exchange that's taking place. Intentionally, though. Like, as they get into it, they are making that establishment. I guess that's what's happening to Usher. The more of you I have, the more of you I want. So it's like this craving of energy. And the way that he put it, I think later on in the song, is how, let's just wait till we get to it. Greetings, love and light. Beautiful energy coming through this rising. Greetings, sis. We're sitting here listening to this song from Usher. It's called Tell Me, a new song for me. But we're talking about how energy is the exchange more than a sexual exchange. And this song with him saying he just wants to wait until her soul lets him in. Just to bring attention to the fact of what this is that we're doing when we're actually exchanging ourselves with people. I wasn't just pulling that out my ass. I just had to bring it to a reference because this song came on last night and I was like, wow, this is the point of what I'm speaking of. This is the whole series. Ah, yes, ma'am. Abundant blessings. I cannot wait to get with you. That's why I have you here. I cannot wait to get with you. I can't wait for us to get some stretching done. You're going to get me into shape. I know that for sure. You're going to help me with my split. You're going to help me with my any and every stretch that I have some issues with. I'm not where I want to be. And that is why I can't wait for us to start getting together. And that will be soon. I'm getting my life together over here on this end. But yeah, guys, just... Where's the part? I'm like, this song is 8 minutes. That's another thing, too. Like, I was like, what in the hell has this song been? When did it come out? It's a whole session, Usher. And all this stuff that's coming out now is just the way that I listen to music now. Even hearing Usher, listening to this song, I'm like, when the fuck did this come out? Bro was being so abused. Like, I just hear the abuse in it now. Like, I can't hear a Justin Bieber. It's so sick how entertainment has conditioned us. Hollywood has conditioned us and hypnotized us to think that it's one thing, and now we're seeing how it's something totally different. Years ago, I kept saying that this shit was coming down. Stop believing in your most high entertainers. But yeah, it's really sickening to see those that you felt like you knew them. Like, we probably feel like we know Usher. We've known him. He's been in front of us, entertaining us all of our lives, like, since we were little. Multiple generations. And then to find out what's been going on behind the scenes. Listening to this song, it was just like, damn, Usher. Damn, Puffy Flavor Camp fucked him up when he was a little, like, from the beginning. That's crazy, man. Like, how many people wanted him and Chili to work? I wanted him and Chili to really be a thing. Chili probably broke up with him because she knew Diddy was hitting that shit and gave him herpes. And okay, this man says, I done missed the part now. Talking about him being sexually abused. When you're so wet, I'm so hard. When two become one, it's like, oh my God. It's feeling like the spirit wants to leave our body. Leave our body. Until your soul lets me in. You want to listen to that one more time? I don't want them to cut me off. So hard to become one. So hard, God, it feels like the spirit wanna leave our body.
Yes, see, ain't the only one get my life together, girl. I'm telling you, it's a thing. But when we start, it's no stopping. Like, I feel that. I feel the reason I have to wait now is because, I mean, divine timing, of course. But I have to, there's a waiting period. But when there's divine alignment, and when it actually happens and takes place, it's like once we start, it's gonna be ongoing until it's done. Hope that makes sense to you and resonate with you, because that is the plan the spirit has already given me. Okay. I can't wait. I cannot wait. I feel like we've already known each other. Excuse us, guys. This is Queen Q. Please go and follow her. She's a delight and such a reflection. And I can't wait for her to assist me in my stretching journey and getting my flexibility where I know that I can push through the mental barriers to get to. She's the one. Like, Spirit told me already. You it, girl. You it. But yeah, okay. That was a sidebar. This song it just speaks volumes to the fact that whether you are going into a sexual exchange intentionally with the intention to create something with this person, whether you go in there with the intention or not, just know something is being created. Something's being cultivated. Energy is being exchanged. So for me, why I can't have just casual, reckless, empty sex is because I just can't. Like, it just can't be casual, empty, and reckless for no reason. It has to be for some substance. If it's just going to please me, I just want something. That's what I'm getting out of this. Just make sure that your mind is in a space where you are only there for what you're there for. And you're not open to any and everything just coming up on you. You are just opening your spirit, opening your womb, opening your world up to whatever this person has on them. No, like, you want to go in there, especially if you're going in there with, you got a motive. This is the only reason you're going to do this is because you try and get one off. That's your motive. Okay. I get it. But make sure that you're also protecting yourself from unwanted energy, unintended energy, misdirected energy, energy that's not yours or not intended for you. Because when you're in that intimate, sacred exchange, while it's happening, you have no control over it. The energy is exchanging, whether it's good, bad, or ugly. So that's what I'm saying. I can't just go with somebody that, I mean, I'm not feeling, I don't have no type of insight or finger on their pulse to see how their world looks, because I've had an encounter where I don't know what the hell was going on with me after an exchange. Like, and it was because this is when I first started realizing what sex really is. Like, that it is a sexual exchange, that it's a soul exchange. And my only two adult relationships have been my son's dad, and that was from a teenager to an adult. He transitioned when my son was 5 years old. And then the person whose arms I went right into was my son's godmother, was my ex, who I stayed with for damn near a decade. And those are the only two adult relationships. One man, one woman. So after getting out of a relationship with her, I knew that I wasn't going to be with another woman. But it's just like, okay, how do I even allow a man to love me? And give him let my guard down to not tell him how to love me. Like, okay, you can't do this, you can't do this, and you can't do this. You can't make me feel this way. You can't cheat on me because I've never been cheated on before. I don't have, like, you can't do things that I am not
okay with, if that makes sense. So I had an issue with going into dating. Like, how am I going to navigate even sex with other people? So when I had sex with people in the very beginning of my healing journey, it was just like, I felt depressed. I felt like the most icky feelings, and I did not know what was going on. So long story short, as I grew and became celibate on purpose, not by force, but by choice, you know, you save yourself because you're literally terrified. I was petrified. I didn't know what was going on every time I had sex. Like, what is this that I feel? I felt nasty, and it was just energy. And that's when it was like, as I was evolving and as I was opening my spirit was just very clear, very open, and very loud. This is when I was healing myself. I had to get away from all the things that were distracting me, relationship, work, everything, and really get into what I was feeling or what my spirit was telling me to do. So when it came to sex, right, it was like, okay, I don't like the way I feel after I have sex. And for me, sex is not a thing that I have to have. Like, I never understood when I was growing up how my cousin was like, I need some dick. Wait, you need it? It's like, if you don't have it, what's going to happen? What's going to happen? And it's like the craving of once they started to have sex, it's like, I got to have it. I got to have it. And that was just never me. I would be around. They would have older men. They like, damn, we are 15 and your boyfriend's 19 and 20. Like, I was scared of that. I was just too little wet behind the ears for that. Like, I was very intimidated by someone having me that vulnerable. So growing up, it was just like, okay, yeah. And by the time I was with my ex, she was number 5. I was still counting on my hands. And I took very much pride in that. But it was like, I had to put that guard down. Like, okay, Shanita, you are an adult. It is okay to go off of your hand with them. Once I realized people's numbers, like, I was oblivious to how many people really had sex with. Like, for real. I was like, wait, what the bodies? And my cousin, oh my gosh, I'm not going to mention her name. But when I found out how proud she was at the number of bodies she had, it's like, baby, you better thank the good God above that your box is still boxing. Like, how the fuck has that many dicks been inside of you? Like, what in the fuck? Oh, and then to think about somebody not being aware of how to remove these niggas' energy from them. Like, what in the fuck? You know how long their energy stays if you just don't remove it or release it from you? So think about the back up, the pile up of energy that is in her womb. And now we're at a place where you want to have a child. And work has to be done to reverse all that back up energetically. There is no space for a baby to dwell. There is too much energy there. You have to go in there and start digging them niggas up. Like, they are in caskets, buried. You have to go in there and get them niggas, for real. Because energetically, it's like, it's no way possible for you to get to the other side of conceiving. How do you think that that's going to happen when the energy in your womb is so compact and it's so, this is heavy. The important point is being very aware of who you're laying down with. Being mindful of what's going to take place after that laying down. I'm so intentional that I, because there was a time, even when I was after that, it was just like, allow yourself permission to be a grown ass woman, you know? And I went through this phase of, I'm just going to fuck whoever I feel like fucking. I want to fuck them. Like, if it feels, if the energy feels good. So that is how I knew. I went from being terrified of having sex to trying to prove a point that I'm grown. And that ended up being the other five on the other hand. And it's like to compare, right? It feels like I know tangibly what I received from each interaction. Like something came of it. There was a manifestation of it. So moving forward and dating and, you know, getting to know people on an intimate level, it's not an automatic decision. I tap into my womb. My womb had, ever since I have tapped into her, named her, she done got a name change and everything. Like, we weren't playing. She didn't even want to be called who she was called when we was with the last person. Like, no, don't even reference me as that. The fuck? Like, no. Who are we? And I had to really get into who she is outside of me being with that person. I only identified to her as what she identified to her as. Like, no, we're not doing that. We're not doing that. Oh, what's your name? I don't have on my glasses today, but thank you for sharing that. Oh my goodness, you stopped having sex recklessly at 38, celibate on purpose. I'm telling you, that will change the game. When you say, okay, I respect my womb enough to not give it up freely and just, you know, recklessly. Oh my goodness, the way you're going to be rewarded. Your womb was like, oh, you deserve something in someone that's going to be, oh, I'm so grateful that now at 40, you have found, well, your person has found you. That's beautiful. That's a beautiful story. I love that. Thank you for sharing. Oh, thank you. Thank y'all so much for being here and engaging. I'm glad that this, my intention when I first, because I was up late last night. So I said, when I get up today, I'm just going to chant. I'm just going to chant on there. And then this Usher song came on. I was like, I would have to dissect that. I need to get into that. But, yeah, to just wrap up, even when it comes down to your intentions when you're laying down with someone, it's like, start asking the questions. If they can't answer the questions, then they can't lay with you. You know, like, I need to lay with somebody that has intentions, like that has somewhere that they're trying to go. Because if they subconsciously have somewhere where they're going, when they climax, whether it's intentional with y'all two or not, it's like they're going somewhere. It's not just going to be empty. Their subconscious, their highest self is really taking them somewhere. So I had to realize the quality of a sex partner. Come on, let's get into it. The quality of someone that you're actually going to have sex with. What the fuck is on their mind? What are they doing when they leave you? That matters. That's the energy that you're going to be left with. So how are they treating the people in their lives? How are they treating their children? How are they treating their parents? How are they treating people just randomly? All of that is going to be a part of who you are now once you lay with this person. So you have to start paying attention to how they move. What are they doing? Because that is now how you're going to be moving and doing. That's just what has been at my forefront with this dating shit. Like, all right. The last couple of people that I've experienced, it's been interesting because what Spirit has done for me is gave me that test to see okay, are you still in that I'm just gonna fuck because I want to fuck phase? Or are you back to, you know, knowing your worth and respecting yourself? Because it could very well be I'm just having sex with somebody because that's what's next in the situation. We go out on a few dates, you know, and that's just what's next. That's what happens. No, I put a halt, stop, pause on that shit. Like, that's not what happens next. It doesn't happen until it happens for me. Like, a whole lot of other things have to happen before that to happen. Before that to happen next. It's like, I have to feel totally comfortable. It can't just be, I went out with you one time. Now, skirt, skirt. Don't get too holy, Shanita. If the energy, have I had a one-night stand before? Yes, absolutely. One of those on that hang. But that was also me going into it. This is what the fuck I'm going. It was empowering for me because I felt like I switched the role in that. I really did. I knew that I was only going to have sex with him this time, and that was what it was going to be for me, and that was it. So, it was, like I said, empowering for me because I had never done that. I had never moved like that. Like, yeah, I'm about to hit this, and that's going to be it. That was, in my mind, so gangsta of me. But, to have something on your mind when you're actually going to lay down with this person. You know, what are the good qualities that you have already seen in them? Talk to them about what their desires, what they want next in their life. How is it that you two together can bring their reality, bring your reality? Sex magic has been something that I have intrigued in, so intrigued in, diving into, like, just really interested in practicing it with someone, but I haven't had the opportunity to feel comfortable enough to even feel like I can have a conversation up with somebody about sex magic. Like, it just been a guard up until there hasn't been a guard up. So it's like, just to be intrigued by, I wonder if, not I wonder, I can't wait to manifest some shit with this person. Like, it's going to be so magical when both of us lay down with the intention of increasing all the energy that the other person has about their dreams and goals. Like, it's going to be so magical. But to be able to have a totally different perspective, you have to take yourself out of the empty, casual, reckless sex. You are weakening your creative force. You're weakening your chi energy. You're weakening who you are, like, because it's constantly diminishing your essence. Like, give your essence time to grow some strength to have a mighty blow. Like, so that it can be impactful and it's not just empty and frivolous. Another thing I wanted to talk about is the how we nurture and care for our sacral chakra. The foods that you eat. The sacral chakra is orange. Orange foods, the color orange. Just being mindful as you go throughout your day. Just something orange. If it's foods that are orange, whatever. But just dedicate orange things, orange colors. Wear something orange today with the intention of it bringing some healing to your sacral chakra. But also, Kings, you need to make sure that you are treating your man with kindness, respect, loyalty, dedication. Make sure he is good inside and out. When you start to notice that there is something going wrong, maybe some things are delayed, or some things are not as, you know, as we would like, take time to dig into why. Get some capsules. I have some capsules for you if you need them. They are jam-packed with all the herbs that will help you with your blood flow, stamina, detoxing, bacteria, you know. I have scrotum steams. I have scrotum polish. I have detox capsules. So it will get you in a place where, and for the detox kit, you're going to have to practice semen retention. You can't have sex for 6 days, 6 to 7 days. On the seventh day, you're going to ejaculate, and you cannot allow that semen to go on any parts of a woman because it's all toxic. And what you're going to be doing throughout the week as you're detoxing internally and externally, because the soap that you're going to be using, the scrotum polish you're going to be using, all of that is jam-packed with herbs. So you're going to be releasing, shaking up and releasing all these damn germs, bacteria, dead cells, everything that just should not be there that's causing the blood flow to slow down, causing your man to take his time getting up and staying up, you know? So just take your time when it comes to clearing the way. Like I said, there's a backup in some wounds. Y'all got bodies on y'all shit too. Y'all got women just laying around on y'all dick like this. Like, because you ain't thought to get that bitch up off of there. You ain't thought to get her up off of there. You thought after you left her that she was done. No, she's still sitting there. Mm-hmm. Waiting to jump on the next woman that you encounter. So just know that there is a practice to healthy sexual hygiene. Like, womb care, scrotum care is imperative these days. And we can't, I'm a part of changing the conversation or changing the narrative. Like, let's pivot into having conversations and intentional dating, purposeful dating, and not just out here swiping left and right just to hook up with people. That had become the most annoying, irritating, stomach, nauseating thing for me. It's just so vain. We're swiping left and right. When we meet up, it's just like, damn, I only liked you because you was cute. You ain't got shit in that head of yours. It's so disappointing. Like, I hated meeting people on the app. I did. It's just so annoying and in the way. It's like, okay, so do I gotta stop picking people that ain't cute, people that's ugly, like to connect with them for them to have something on their mind? Because the people that I'm attracted to is just like, what the fuck, guys? Like, what's going on? This is who's left? Shit. Yeah, but I give thanks for experiences. Just all experiences, because it allows me to know what I want and what I don't want. I wait to 40 to start dating for real. Like, I wait till I turn fucking 40 years old to be like, okay, I'm dating. Shit, this shit is lethal. This shit is lethal. So this here, because I'm fed up. I haven't been on those dating apps in months now at this point. And it's just like, but you have to go places if you want to meet people, girl. Like, get yourself out there. I don't want to do none of that. So I'm trusting spirit to lead, guide, direct my person. I'm feeling good energetically right now. I'm in a space where I feel cozy. I'm comfortable right here. And oh my God, yes, especially if they're laying down with other people. Grand rising queen. Beautiful rising, my love. How are you? I love you. I hope you have an amazing day. Dreams, mom. Yeah, the people that they're laying down with. Because when we get up from there, we have to know for sure that we're getting up with something. So if we're laying down with them recklessly and we just doing it just because we want to do it, we're just satisfying our flesh. Like I was talking about yesterday, don't be out here having plan B sex. You having sex that if this man busts up in you, you're gonna go get a plan B the next morning. Why is that even something you're entertaining? That's what I'm saying. Like, what is on this person's mind? Where are they going tomorrow? Where are they going when they leave you? Because that's the energy you're going to be sitting in. And if it's not worth it, don't exchange your energy with that person. Just do not. Like, let's just have enough self-control not to forcefully make our womb go into something that's not going to benefit her. Alike, kings, don't just hit the jump because it's there. Have enough self-respect. Let me tell you something that women will sit back and be turned on about. A man with some self-control. Oh my God. Who don't have to have sex. Who can chill it out. You know? That's a turn on. Like, have some self-control. Find out if she really want to have sex. Like, see it. Let her initiate it. Because the automatic expectation of this is what's supposed to happen next. Like, that's what I mean. When it comes to this date and stuff. This man, you are not. Just because that date went good does not mean I'm about to be your girlfriend. No. That's not what that means. Because I feel the other women on you. And even with this person, I did. So sleeping with him was my choice. On me, wasn't no force, didn't feel like anything. But I shouldn't have done that because I knew how he felt prior to having sex with him. He wanted me. And I knew I did not want him. I was just going to have sex. And it was just going to be that. But I, after having sex, that want became, it was very intensified. Like, it was very, and it was just a turn off. To the point where it was like aggression out of the fact that I don't want to be, like, really? What if I would have said yeah? And everything would have been great. What about the next thing I would have said no to? Like, it was just, it was just a lot. And being mindful that you have energy on you before, during, and after you're in that situation. And what you do with it once you get up. For me, I got them bitches up off me. I got them up off me. I knew I'm in a practice now where I know to cleanse myself, whether it's steaming, whether it's herbal douche, whether it's prayers, whether it's touching my womb, doing fire breaths. There's going to be some holy work. There's going to be some sacred work taking place when it comes down to realigning myself, getting myself back to a place of desired balance, getting back to me. Because I don't want to be walking around feeling insecure, jealous, possessive, all of these things that I'm not because I refuse to get other people's energy off me. Because this man walk around with his ex on him. He walk around with somebody he just met on him. He walk around with, man, all them people very much, yes, waiting to jump on your ass. Waiting. So just be mindful of the energy you're carrying around and the energy that the person that you're laying with is carrying around. I've become very good at just trusting my womb and trusting my heart. If it feels good to me, I can go with it. I have that much trust in my womb now that she's just like, okay, she's going to let me lead the way. When I hear her say no, there it's a no. I don't care all the sweet nothings you're saying that make me think it sounds good. My womb is not pleased. My womb is preparing me, protecting me from something that you have on you that we just can't have. You look amazing. You sound amazing. You smell amazing. But my womb said no. And the more I got to honoring her, the more I got to asking her, is this a good one or no? She's like, no, boo. Mm-mm. And then she tell me, yeah, this one. And I'm just like, but he ain't acting like he wanted. No, but it's this one. I'm like, I don't know about this one. She's like, yeah, save yourself for this one. I'm like, all right, I guess, whatever. Okay. And then this one started to like, but we're gonna talk about that.
Okay, I think spirit is let up. Y'all have been so gracious this rising. Thank you for engaging. I just knew I was about to be on here. We can't close out with that though. That was my intention to get up here and chant. But all of that came up with that Usher song. Tell me. Go listen to Usher Tell Me. Because he explains all that. My whole point is that once you get in that vulnerable space with someone, it is all about the energy that's exchanging. It has nothing to do with the bodies that are present. It has everything to do with the spirits that are there sharing thoughts, ideas, goals, like, or they're there fussing as you're fucking. Like, you, if there's not no alignment, there's something going on in the spirit realm in that room too. So when you leave there, you want to know, wondering why this person acting the way they acting. You thought they liked you before, and now it's a trip out. Your spirit did not approve of that exchange. You were not even supposed to lay down with that person. Now it's making sense. So after so many of those aha moments, it's like, okay, I'm sorry. What do you want? Who do you want? Who are we going to entertain? And you will find yourself celibate on purpose. You will find yourself protecting your essence, building up that life force energy. So when you do find the one that you're going to exchange it with, it's so beautiful. It's so potent. It's so intentional. It's so magical. Like, you're going to draw something to you. Whether you think you are or not, something is being brought to you. And go into that situation with that being your intention. I'm working magic. Work magic with the wand, people. There is magic there in that exchange. Ta-da! Okay? So get what you want out of the situation. Don't just let the situation dictate how you move. Have a conversation with that person before y'all even lay down. Like, where are we going when we lay down? Let's go somewhere. Let's actually go to a destination. Let's go to a spot in your future or a spot in my future. Because, baby, when you guys play with that energy, how powerful and potent that energy is, and how you can manipulate it to do and go wherever you want it to go. This is just what I've been learning as I've been doing research and sex magic. Like, and I'm such a magical ass witch that I know when I practice sex magic and how powerful my womb is, oh, it's gonna be lit. It's a wrap. Y'all gonna be looking at me like, oh yeah, she started doing some magic. She started doing some magic. That's the only thing that I'm missing. I think that my spirit guides have been waiting for me to be comfortable when it comes to my sensuality and releasing insecurities that I've had, body shaming myself, just a whole lot of things that I had to overcome as a woman before I realized how much magic I do have within my womb. Yeah. I realized how the force against me, like, to acknowledge the devil is to know that the devil is real. And I don't acknowledge that nigga. I don't say the devil about nothing. He don't get credit in my world. He don't dwell in my world. He don't try to tempt me. He don't do nothing over here. Maybe back in the day when I was a Christian, but not anymore. The devil don't do shit over here. But there's an energy that will try to take your light out
And people are worshiping the devil. People work for him. So you don't have to be engaged with the devil. You got his workers out here. They can be so demonic that they pull that light. They put your fire out just by being around you. It's important that we know how to guard our wounds and our scrotum spaces, because people will come to you deliberately to put your light out, put your flame out, just to disrupt your essence. And being mindful about that as you go out into this world will allow you to stay in your energy more, you know, protect your energy more, be more of a light, letting that light shine a little brighter throughout the day. And it's not as dull as you come in. No, you are in control of who has access to that. Yeah, you're in control of who has access to that. And do not be, don't be wasteful. Like, because your womb will treat you as such. Don't treat her like anything. Don't disrespect her. Don't treat her like she just, because she will fucking fight back. She will get your attention and fight the fuck back. Bitch, you've been disregarding me all this fucking time. And now that I'm giving you, now that I'm making you itch, you want to ask questions about me? Nah, bitch, itch. Itch. She's going to make you itch. I'm sorry, that was very personal. I felt like, I mean, I knew I had someone in mind when I was talking about that. And it's simply because I've been doing this work for a minute. A lot of people know me only as O'Abby. They don't even know Shanita. They don't know Sean. They don't know Neat. They know O'Abby. That is how I was introduced to them in their life. They know me as a sacred woman. Some people, most people, even especially on social media, they only know me as O'Abby. This work that I have grown to just love, and it's so intimate to me, the sacral chakra, your womb. In my work, I was getting overwhelmed in the beginning because I felt like I gave more fucks about people pussy than they gave fucks about their own. And it's like, why and how are you only asking for temporary fixes? How are you asking to be tighter and you're not dealing with the fucking odor? How are you asking? How are you asking to be wetter and you're not, and you discharging like that? Because it's only for the temporary gratification of wanting to please somebody else during sex. Get your shit together first. Sex don't have to be nowhere on the radar. Let the sex with yourself be the goal. I have come across so many women who are just out here pleasing men with their wounds just to please the men. Oh my God. I had someone that was near and dear to me. Not to say that she's not anymore, but near and dear, who suffered from BV repetitively. And this is when I first found out that BV is a sexually transmitted disease. And it broke my heart to tell my girl, hey, baby, bruh ain't doing something right. Bruh is cheating on you, especially after you keep getting this shit treated. Then I realized that men have to treat it too, which is why I did the scrotum detox kit. Because so many women were coming to me with BV. And it's like, if men don't know that they're giving it to you, or if they do know that they're giving it to you, maybe they'll be more cautious. But once men start to learn how BV is transferred, they will start to do what they need to do not to transfer it. Because BV takes place when one woman's flora comes in contact with another woman's flora, vaginal juices, and then that creates the imbalance of those hormones and juices, and BV is created right then and there. So he goes to sleep with this woman, no condom, all her essence get on him. He goes to sleep with this woman, no condom. Those essences join together. There's BV. He now has BV on his dick. That woman now has BV. When he goes back to that woman, she now has BV. So then these two women are suffering from itching, odor, discharge, and he has not one symptom. He does not know that he has anything that he's transferring back and forth. Until you stop him and say, King, bruh, if you had sex with her raw and you had sex with her raw, you have BV and you're passing it around. So now even the next one that you have sex with, you're going to give her BV. You're going to throw her balance completely off. She's now going to be smelling. She's now going to be itching. She's now, like, BV is just in an uproar. At one point in time, that's all I was treating was BV. So when men got to realizing, oh shit, really? I started to come into contact with kings who gave a fuck about their scrotum, who was literally practicing semen retention. A man told me about semen retention. A king, a divine king who came to me and was getting his bitters, his beard oil, his detox capsules. He was on a mission and he said he's practicing semen retention. And I'm like, what is that? Way to go. Way to fucking go to practice semen retention. He broke it down and all that it meant to him. Bruh, we need you out here normalizing that. Thank you. Go tell your brothers and your homies this shit so that they are cleansing themselves between women. That's all we need to start doing, y'all. We need to just start being very mindful of the people that we're encountering. Like, respecting yourself enough to cleanse yourself before, energetically and spiritually. I'm not talking about taking a fucking shower. I'm talking about cleansing your spirit, cleansing your womb, cleansing your scrotum, cleansing the energy of that person. It's going to take for you to go in prayer. It is beyond you physically where that energy is laying or resting on you. You have to go to your higher self. You have to go spiritually. You have to go to another dimension to get that shit up off you. So it takes time to go to that place to say, I give thanks for this exchange. I give thanks for what this person brought to my life. I give thanks for what I gave this person. But I would like for this person to now be free of my, or like, free myself of this person. Out of my essence, she must go. He must go. Steaming yourself with releasing the energy of that person from your sacral area. Saying their name, and they have to go. Before you go lay with somebody else, or it's going to be all of y'all laying in the bed together. Okay? Okay. Okay. I think I'm done. I think I am done. Girl, yes. Yes. And people don't like to talk about it, but I'm here to talk about everything people don't like to talk about. You have a great day as well, love. Full of prosperity and blessings. You as well. Especially if they're laying down with other people. You better know it, baby. You better know it. It's imperative. Something else I want to say before I go. Nothing is permanent. Nothing. Everything is reversible. Nothing is on you to stay on you. It's only about when you decide that you want to release that shit up off you. You demand it to leave your body. You demand it to go. It cannot dwell here. Doesn't make you feel good. Tell your womb you want it to go. And your womb will say, well, this is what you have to do in order for us to let it go. What are you going to sacrifice? It's not going to be no fucking breeze. You did this to us. So what are you going to do? Are you going to eat better? Are you going to make better decisions? Are you going to stop having sex for 3 months? Are you going to do this? Are you going to do that? You have to make a deal. A spiritual contract with your body. Make an agreement with your body to say, hey, I don't want this. What can I do for you for us to get rid of this? Body, I love you. I'm here to take care of you every single day. I respect you. Hug yourself and ask yourself, touch your womb. If you don't already have a relationship with her, it's time for you to name her. It's time for you to get acquainted with what she wants, what she desires, because she will tell you what it takes to rid yourself of energy, rid yourself of disease, rid yourself of heartache, rid yourself of BV, rid yourself of all these things that are left on you when you, after sex. Let's start being very responsible. Let's start being very vocal about what we want, what we demand for ourselves. Tell your body what you want. Your body does what it's supposed to do naturally, yes. But if there's something there that should not be there, you have to go here to remove it. There's a factory in your mind that is orchestrating everything within your body. Go to the room that is dedicated to your womb. Spend some time there. It's going to require a meditation. This can't just be something you think you're going to pray and it's going to go away. This takes work. Dedication. You're going to have to dedicate yourself to releasing whatever it is from your body. I healed myself. I know what the fuck it takes. I know what it looks like to rid your body of something that you don't want to be there. I need to go. Spirit is heavy. Like, it's going to keep on getting me engulfed. I'm going to go now, though. I'm going to go now. Thank you guys so much. So much for your engagement this rising. It feels really good to commune with like mine. And for I just tell spirit, I just want the right mind, the right spirit, the right energy to be in my space and in my aura at all times. And that includes social media. So when I have myself and I'm open and I'm vulnerable, my guard is down and I'm on here, it has to be at 5:55. I mean, it may be throughout the day sometimes, other times, but this is where I feel most comfortable because the bullshitters are not really all up in here yet. So when I attract those lights that I do attract at 5:55, I'm very grateful for your time, your energy, coming into this space, making it something in the moment, and also making it something that is so powerful for people to look at after it's already recorded in real time. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Have the most amazing day. Overcome adversity and become a better you. Oh, Abby, is a lifestyle. Peace.